I don't want a pickle. Just want to ride my motorcycle. And I don't want a tickle. I'd rather ride my motorcycle.
Welcome to my channel. I want to talk about Reedvalst today. But first, I want to show you something on YouTube. This is my YouTube channel, and about 99% of all the videos are about motorcycle topics. Two-stroke. Fuck the four-stroke. Two-stroke. And I want you to notice something. What is the first video that I made concerning motorcycles? One about reed valves. This is it. And in this video, I cut off the supporting rib and put in an additional plate to cover this area right here as support and made my own reed pedal, and that's what I did. This shows the plate. I don't think that's necessary. This is the reed valve for the Suzuki AX100. This is how it comes, and then when you cut off half of those supporting ribs, you're opening up, I think it's 44 divided by 36. You're opening up that area by 22%. And then you've got to make your own reed pedal out of fiberglass or carbon fiber. And this is what it comes with, the steel. And this idea is from way back when, with this video right here. Here's another video. This guy's doing the same thing. He's making his own reeds out of carbon fiber, which has an advantage and a disadvantage. The advantage to carbon fiber, you can cause a curve to be in that material by heating it up and bending it while it's hot. If you hold it over like maybe 8 inches over a candle flame, that will get it hot enough. And then as you put that curve in it, it will hold that curve. And that's for it to curve toward the tip of the reed valve, so it will seal better, which is beneficial at low RPM. This is my webpage that has the videos organized into groups of topics. This is the web page right here. And so you can see, and there's active links for all of them. So you can pick and choose what you want to watch. Wealth of information. Also, if you go to my web page, lots of information. I got back into this topic of reed valves because I wanted to improve my 48cc, which has a small two-pedal reed valve. This reed valve is definitely restrictive. And so I replaced it with this, and I made my own reed pedal for it out of 0.25 millimeter fiberglass. And I got an 8% increase in speed and power. And these are the graphs that my newest reed valve calculator created for these three setups. It's two different reed valves, and this one is with 0.25 millimeter thick fiberglass, and this one's with 0.13 millimeter thick fiberglass. The blue zone is where there's little to no pressure difference fore and aft of the reed valve due to flow restriction. This line out here from blue to orange is the 102 meters per second flow rate at which pressure starts to happen across the reed valve. And it's more critical up in the red zone. This is interesting. The percent here that's underneath that 102 line is 92% of the total. What is 92%? It's 8% less than 100%. So when I went from that to that, I gained 8%. And look, that 8% is this right here. So I'm not going to say that that's always going to be true on all evaluated reed valves, but it was true for this case. Let me show you the calculator. This is it. Sheet 1 is the carburetor calculator, and sheet 2 is the reed valve calculator. And right here is sources for different reed valve, reed pedal material of fiberglass and carbon fiber. So the two most important things about this calculator is its ability to calculate the resonant RPM of the reed, which is this right here, in max RPM. The idea being that if the reed selected for your reed valve has a lower resonant RPM than what your engine reaches, then it's very possible that you're going to have flutter when you're at top RPM. And when that reed valve starts to flutter, that means it's it starts vibrating out of sync with the engine and you lose power. So in this case, with too thick carbon fiber, it's got a really high RPM, and the AEX only revs to 9,000, so it's not anywhere near that, which is okay. It's just, ideally, you would want the engine RPM to be close to that. And the other thing that is very important that it calculates is the flow speed, the air going through the reed windows underneath the pedals. Ideally, that's going to be below 102, below this line right here. On these notes, you can see I wrote the resonant RPM for each one of these. And the original is too high, since the bike only revs at 7,000. So this one at 8.8 and this one 8.4 is closer to what it actually is, so that's better. And the airflow, the original being 123 and these two modifieds at 63 and 99. So those are the two main points. So you can see here with the AX100, the original setup has a really high airspeed going through it, because it's a flat half reed valve. It doesn't have six windows, it's only got three. And it's a 100cc. And so you can see how thick that red zone is right there. So, you know, which is what Suzuki wanted. They wanted it to be a low-power street bike. So they restricted it in this manner. So when you go to 0.38 millimeter fiberglass or 0.25 millimeter carbon fiber, you're able to lessen that red zone, which is basically you're lowering the airspeed going through it, because you're opening up the flow area and you're allowing the thinner, more flexible reeds to open up more. So the options that you have are to cut off the struts or leave it as is, and whether or not you want to make your own reed pedals, and you'll have to select the material and the thickness. The goal being maximum reed flexibility without lowering resonant RPM too much. And you have to choose the material and thickness to achieve that. And here again is the advantages and disadvantages to carbon fiber and fiberglass. They both have their place. I've seen many reed valves for engines that have carbon fiber that should have fiberglass. So when you do that, you're just creating an additional flow resistance that shouldn't be there. Okay, I'm going to try to explain why an excessive pressure loss across the reed valve is unproductive or negative in its effects. The flow rate is linear in response to the pressure difference or the vacuum that the crankcase has up to a point, up to 102 meters per second. Above that, instead of continuing on with a linear response, you get a non-linear response right here. So that when you apply this much vacuum, you would expect this much flow rate, but you don't get that. You get this flow rate. Okay? So this area right here is what you want to avoid because it gives you less performance per vacuum. So a correctly designed reed valve keeps you in this area right here, below 102 meters per second going through the reed valve, through the windows. And that's that. So I guess that's it for now. If you have any questions, please put them in the comments. Thanks so much for watching.